Hey there everyone, it's Michael Dougal with EXP Realty. During this video today, I'm going to share with you our latest numbers here in the Toronto real estate market. Take a look at the 5-year historical average price and the change. Clearly, 2021 has realized the highest values in the GTA. And I'm going to share with you all the numbers, but if you have not yet subscribed, then consider subscribing and drop a comment so I know that you're watching this video. And let's jump into this first chart over here, which shows a month-by-month breakdown of the really important metrics. So sales, active listings, months of inventory, the average price, and DOM, which stands for days on market. And so this information is for the first half of the year. Be sure to stay tuned to the end of the video where I'll share with you my market predictions for the second half of the year. Taking a look first at the number of sales. In January, there was just about 7,000 sales. In February, it increased to 11,000. March, we experienced the most active time of the year with over 15,000 sales. In April, it decreased to just over 13,000. And then May and June were really quite similar. May, 11,951, and in June, 11,106. So this is pretty common that the number of sales in June is less than what it was in May as we transition into the summer. So this is, based on my experience, a pretty traditional real estate market. The only thing which stands out is the fact that there were more sales in March versus April, whereas usually in April, there are more sales than there are in March. And looking at the number of active listings, it really increased from February to March. And since then, we're seeing that the number of new listings is growing at the same rate as the number of sales, which is why that's fairly stable. In March, there was 10,603 active listings. In April, 11,668. In May, there was 12,253. And then in June, there was 11,297 active listings. So why is this happening? In the fact that June overall doesn't really look like the market was better, but there are fewer listings. And it could have been such that sellers maybe decided to take their home off the market. And there's a lot of reasons for this. During the first couple months of the year, the prices were really high, but what seemed to happen in March and April was it was like the sellers caught on to the fact that prices were outrageously high. So they started to overprice their properties. So we noticed there was a lot of kind of like greedy sellers out there looking for like higher than market value and pretty much just trying their luck. So it could have been such that in June, many of these sellers decided to take their home off the market and wait it out until the market improves even further. I'm taking a look at the months of inventory, which is a good way to tell whether it's more of a market that's favoring sellers versus favoring buyers. So in simplicity, not to make it too complex, the lower this number is, the better it is for sellers, and the higher the number is, the better it is for buyers. So in January, it was at 1.1. In February, 0.8. In March, only 0.7. Like I mentioned, March being the best month to sell your home. April, it increased to 0.9. And we can see again that May and June were very similar. May having 1.03 as the months of inventory and June at 1.02. Now let's take a look at the average price. I think for most agents out there, that's the most common question that you get from the public. How is the average price changing? And what would you predict our home to sell for? So the average price clearly has gone up. Again, like I mentioned, in the initial chart I showed you with the 5-year historical average price change, the average price was $967,000 in January. It increased to over $1 million for the first time in history in Toronto to $1,045,000 in February, increased further to $1,097,000 in March. Then we saw a slight decrease to $1,090,000. And then we saw an increase from April to May, May being at $1,108,000, and June had a very slight decrease, but nothing too significant, back to $1,089,000, which is similar to that number back in April. Now, taking a look at the days on market, which is how long it takes for a property to sell from the time that it gets listed for sale, it was 24 days back in January. That was when the months of inventory was the highest. February, there was 14 days on the market. March, only 10 days on the market. April, 10 days on the market. In the month of May, it was 11 days on the market. And then in June, it increased to 13 days on the market. And it's real interesting when you hear people say that the market isn't that great anymore. Clearly, these numbers compared to 12 months ago are absolutely fantastic. If you are a seller considering selling, this is a great time to cash out because clearly it looks like being over $1 million is our new normal. Based on this information from February onwards, we can see the days on market was very low, the months of inventory is low, and the average price is over $1 million. But of course, because of the fact that the average price and its changes can be very different in particular areas or particular style of properties, let's take a very deep dive into that right now and take a look at the property type average price in June 2021 versus June 2020. So we've got detached homes, we've got semi-detached homes, we have townhouses, and we have condo apartments. And starting with detached homes, that's the particular style of property that has actually appreciated the most in value. The average price for detached homes sold in June 2020 was $1,127,000, whereas in June 2021, it was $1,407,000, which is a 25% increase. Looking at semi-detached homes in June 2020, the average price was $929,000. Now it's exceeded a million. In June 2021, the average semi-detached home was selling at $1,055,000, which is a 14% increase. Looking at townhouses, it was at $786,000 in June 2020. In June 2021, it was $945,000. That's a 20% increase. So that is the second best after detached homes. And then with condo apartments, they've increased in price as well. They were selling for $631,000 in June 2020, and now in June 2021, they were selling for $683,000, which is an 8% increase. So although we saw very high prices last year, based on this chart here, we can see that 2021 has really been the best year ever by far. In 2021, the average price in June 2021 was $1,089,000. But if we look at June 2020, it was $930,000. In June 2019, the average price was $832,000. In June 2018, the average price was $808,000. And in June 2017, the average price was $791,000. Although that's June 2017, keep in mind that prior to April 2017, the prices were probably higher because that was before the new foreign tax was introduced. So clearly we can see that the prices have only been going up. And if you are a buyer who is thinking about waiting until the market crashes, I would strongly suggest that you reconsider, and more so consider this quote: rather than wait until you buy real estate and then wait. I really hope you found this information helpful. Consider subscribing so you get notified when I post future videos. And if you are an ambitious real estate agent looking to connect for opportunity, let's talk about growing our business together. Reach out to me. My contact information is in the description box below. And if you are considering buying or selling, then call me. My number is 416-671-5218. Don't forget to drop a like, and I will look forward to seeing you all next time.